For this week's trip to the farm, we're moving up from chicken onto bigger animals. Andrea Bushre explains.
Welcome back. We're here at Apsey Farms this week. This week we're going to talk about their livestock. We just turned these guys out into the paddock, and so they're happily munching away. So tell me more about the cattle operation here.
Well, right now we rotational graze these guys. We move them once a day. We put them out on fresh pasture. These guys we try to put out in the evening, sometime when it's not so hot. That way it doesn't, one, it's better for them and it's better for the ground also. In doing the rotational grazing, like we've talked a little bit, it does help the soil and it does also help, it helps the animals and all the stuff so they're not in the same areas all the time. There's approximately 80 animals out here.
Okay.
They range from a year old to 2 years old. We typically keep the 2 years olds to about 30 months, and then we process them after that.
Okay. So I know a lot of people are going to have questions about the difference between grain-fed and grass-fed. Is there a different amount of time that it takes for a cow being fed grass-fed versus
Perfect.
Grain?
Yes. As I said, it takes about 30 months for them to finish out on grass. A typical grain-fed animal will finish out between 16 and 18 months
okay.
in doing so. A lot of people do that. It's just not what we choose. In trying to be more healthy and better for the animals, we chose to go this direction. Best practice is if you take half and leave half, that way it'll regenerate and grow faster back to where it's at.
So we just moved these cattle into their new paddock. This is the cow-calf operation here at Apsey. Tell us a little bit about this spot.
We just moved them into the fresh paddock. Now they'll get moved every day again. So they have fresh grass to eat. It also moves them along and we'll continue to move them across this area of the field so that everything is healthy for them also.
You know, the rotationally grazing these animals helps to regenerate the land. This kind of feeds into what we're talking a lot about here at Apsey, but then also at NanBop about regenerative agriculture and its benefits. So this is kind of seeing it in action. Thank you for tuning in, and we'll see you next week.